We are joined now by Corey Lewandowski and David Bossie. They are authors of the new book, Trump's Enemies, How the Deep State is Undermining the Presidency. Both obviously worked on the Trump campaign. Great to have both of you on. Let me first ask by defining, what does deep state mean? What does that term mean? Who is the deep state?
You know, hey, Brian, thanks for having us. And look, what we talk about in the book, Trump's Enemies, the deep state are those individuals who are either holdovers from the previous administration, or they're individuals who portrayed themselves to be one thing and have come into the administration only to stop this president's agenda and subvert the will of the American people and the 60 million individuals who voted to bring change to Washington, D.C.
So, and Brian, just to expand on that, the deep state is historically been, and it's been around for a long time, is those bureaucrats, right? Those embedded career bureaucrats who have a we own, you rent mentality, meaning elected officials come and go. We are the permanent class of the government. And therefore, we can wait you out. We are going to not do what you want. We are not going to enforce the policies that you were elected to bring forth to the U.S. government. We're going to wait you out, and we own this place. You're just here for a little while.
Well, so
and
who,
that's the big – that's what you layer on what Corey was just talking about, and that's what the deep state is.
So who does he trust then?
Well, look, Brian, you know, the president obviously trusts some of his close advisors. He listens to his family. He listens to guys like Dave and I who are on the outside who can give him a perspective. But when you look at some of the changes that this administration has made in the last year, I think they're very positive and they're in the right direction. When you see a guy like John Bolton who's come into the administration, Bill Shine and the communications team, you see Larry Kudlow come in as the National Economic Advisor, all individuals who knew candidate Trump, Mr. Trump, before becoming President Trump, they're not part of what we define in the book of Trump's enemies as the November 9th Club. There's a whole bunch of people who joined his team after he won, but didn't know him before, didn't support him before, and likely didn't vote for him on Election Day 2 years ago.
All right, so the November 9th Club are those who got on board after November 8th, 2016, when we had the election. Now, wouldn't Larry Kudlow be in that mix? I mean, he was never a big fan of Trump economics. I mean, beforehand, what the president would be considered, or what he would call a globalist, wouldn't he? Or a free trade guy.
No. And look, to be clear, I know Larry Kudlow well. When I was running the campaign, Larry Kudlow, Steve Moore, and Art Laffer came to the campaign early on and outlined and listened to Donald Trump's policy and economic ideas. They came and made recommendations. Larry was there early. Steve Moore was there early. Art Laffer, three of the best economic minds of our country, were there early. And I'm talking early of 2015, going back and forth with ideas, and they helped us write the Trump tax plan, which he unveiled during the campaign. So he was there long before Donald Trump was ever elected.
We're talking with Corey Lewandowski and David Bossie. Their new book out is entitled Trump's Enemies, How the Deep State is Undermining the Presidency. Maybe in that deep state is the person who wrote that op-ed to the New York Times, right? How there was a resistance. Do you guys have an idea? Do you have a theory? Do you think the president knows who this person is? I mean, it's been a while. We still have no idea at this point.
You know, I do believe the president has some ideas, but we do not know who it is. And I don't think the president knows who it is. I think he has some guesses that he has in his mind. But we do know that Anonymous exists. We do know that there are people within this administration who ought not be there. And I think the author of the Anonymous letter ought not be there. And they're not helping this president. And that's the unfortunate part about this. This president has not had 1 minute since his election, not even during the transition. You had this, you know, fake Russia collusion narrative that the Democrats glommed onto to blame that for Hillary Clinton's disastrous loss. They never accepted the results of the election. They always wanted to undermine him and delegitimize this president right from Election Day. And we've never seen that before in American history. So whether he's fighting the left in this country, whether it's the mainstream Democrats, some of the Republican establishment that hasn't gotten behind him, or the mainstream media, for that matter, where 85 or 90% of the news coverage is is negative of him, and that's why he has really educated the American people. And I think that, and he says it in our interview, in Trump's enemies, we actually have an interview with the president that we publish in here, and he says one of the greatest things that he's done during his presidency is making the American people understand the level of the fake news, that the fake news is an enemy of the truth. And that's what he has tried to do, is make sure that the American people know that. And I think that that's really been transformative, but it's also created an enormous fight amongst that the mainstream media now attacks him at every turn.
All right. One of the things people always point to is that, look, a lot of times the president will side with dictators, right? Whether it's Vladimir Putin, what it's the latest with the crown prince of Saudi Arabia. If there is this America first mentality, why does he typically go that route of wanting relationships or siding even with these dictators?
Well, look, the president's talked about this very openly, and I think the American people agree that when there are opportunities for our country to work with other world leaders for the benefit of the global preservation, we have to do that. So when we have to work with Russia so that we can eradicate ISIS, that's something that we should do. When we have to work with Saudi Arabia has been an ally of the United States for a long time. We do a lot of business with Saudi Arabia. Don't kid yourself. You know, we do billions of dollars a year in transactions when it comes to military sales and foreign sales and all kinds of things. But this president's agenda, we talk about it in Trump's enemies, is America first. It's putting America first, because for too long, for the last administration, 10 years, we literally bowed to other world leaders. We made bad trade deals, and the American people have suffered for it.
Absolutely.
And if I could just finish with this thought on that. Look, we all agree. I think the president agrees and has said so openly that the murder of that journalist by the Saudis was unconscionable and horrific, and that he does not support it, and he wants to find changes. However, our country does business with country after country around the world that is a lot worse than that. I mean, we know about this one issue, but the American people, all you have to do is look at the oppression around the world of governments that are
There's no doubt about that, David.
I'm saying is this is one example, and it is a horrific example, and the president has acknowledged it as such. But that doesn't mean he does business with dictators, which was the premise of your question.
Okay, there's no doubt. I mean, it would have been a tough decision no matter who the president was. But I guess my question is, does he trust those governments more than he trusts his own intelligence community?
Look, I don't think so. I think when you look at the information that he gets from his intelligence communities, he listens to it, but he doesn't take everything for granted. He questions. This is what the president's job is to question the intelligence that he's getting from all the sources. Because while we have a great intelligence community, we also understand that the people like, and this is a very big part of our book, Trump's Enemies, Clapper and Comey and Brennan, they have their own political agenda. What they did to undermine this president, what the intelligence community did to go after American individuals on U.S. soil, spying on them, needs to be questioned. And if Donald Trump wasn't elected, we wouldn't know about it. So, look, I know he respects the CIA and the DIA and the NSA and all of those agencies, but you look at the individuals who, until he became the president, was leading those, Jim Clapper, Brennan, Comey. These are bad guys who used badges to go after American citizens who had their own political agenda, who, by the way, had better end up in jail sometime soon, because there are two separate rules, one for everyday Americans and one for individuals who are breaking the Fourth Amendment, lying to FISA courts and spying on American citizens because we don't like your political beliefs. That's shameful, and that's what we outlined.
Those were not his people. He's now in place. You know, he's been president for 2 years. I mean, does he have his people in place? And, you know, you talked about the CIA. The CIA, you know, reportedly said it was highly likely that it was the crown prince that was responsible, that ordered the death of Khashoggi.
Right. And the president, see, that's what the president does. He says, the intelligence community says it's highly likely. They're not saying it's 100%. He is saying, we look at this very seriously. We want to have a balance. And that's what presidents have to do. Whether it is post 9/11, where a vast majority of the 9/11 hijackers, right, were from Saudi Arabia.
Yep.
Think about that. They killed 3,000 Americans. We've been doing business with Saudi Arabia, which is, I'll be honest with you and I'll say it, killing 3,000 Americans is a lot worse than killing the one reporter, okay? And so if we're going to go to war with Saudi Arabia over something, maybe we should have done it over that.
Well,
that's
David,
my position.
David Bossie, Corey Lewandowski. The book is entitled Trump's Enemies, How the Deep State is Undermining the Presidency. Good to have you on.
Hey, thanks, Bryan.
Thanks, Bryan.
8:46 on WBAL.